Okay, so 9th standard student, this video is a continuity part of your last video. And in the last video, what we have learned or what we have studied in the last video regarding the last two videos, means last two videos, what we have learned regarding the aspects of food security. What are the aspects of food security? Okay, so aspects of food security, what we have learned about the buffer distribution, buffer stock and public distribution system, PDS. Okay, buffer stock means making a stock of food grains from the farmers through FCI, and public distribution system means to distribute to the common people of India through the ration card. Okay, so now we will be doing the next topic of your this chapter only, that is the poverty alleviation program. Okay, what is this poverty alleviation program? To overcome your poverty from the country, government has introduced several things, so we will be discussing regarding that. So poverty alleviation program, the government has taken many measures to reduce poverty. Okay, so government already knows that poverty is existing in our society. So government is making some steps, or they are taking some steps so that we can overcome that poverty. This program aimed at, what are the programs they have given, what is the aim or why they are doing this? They are aiming it at creation of jobs to poor people. Some programs they have introduced where, see, poverty is there. I can't go and hit the poverty directly. What are the factors for poverty? We have to overcome that one. Then only there will be no poverty. So these programs aimed at creation of jobs to poor people. Creation of jobs to poor people. Poor people will be getting jobs. They will not be unemployed. They will be having an income to at least buy the basic necessity food for their livelihood. Okay. Increase their purchasing power. Income will be there. They will be having purchasing power to alleviate poverty. These measures can be classified into four groups. They are as follows. Okay. This is the last topic. With these four measures being taken by government, today's video we will be discussing about these two, and in the next video we will be discussing the rest part of this poverty alleviation program. So first one is the economic development measure. Economic development measure, what is this? Economic development and poverty are closely related. Economic development and poverty are closely related. How they are related? If a country is having economic development properly, then there will be no poverty. If it is not there, the economic development, there will be poverty. So they are interrelated. The extent of poverty decline with the country's economic development. Poverty will decline if the country is flourishing with the economic development. Government attempted through 5 years plan, which aimed at overall higher growth rate in incomes and equal distribution of that income among all people. See, to overcome this poverty, government has taken this step of economic development measure. How economic development can be done? There are several factors. Okay, how, or there are several ways in which we have to go, or the government has to go, to eradicate or to make it out from the our economy. Okay, this poverty. So this is one. What is this? Government makes 5 year plan. Okay, in this 5 year plan, what government tell, how much food should be supplied? They take all the statistical reports from different organizations, so that first they have to understand what is there which is existing in my economy. How much is the poverty? How much is my GDP? How much is my per capita income? Where the income I have to do mainly? Okay, means where I have to increase the income or the purchasing power of the people. Which are the places which are badly affected, where people are not getting food for one time? All these things they have to do, and then they will do the 5 year plan. Means coming 5 years we will be do like this so that we can have a steady economic development so that people will be flourishing with their own growth. So government attempted through 5-year plan which aimed at overall higher growth rate in income, income should be more, and equal distribution of that income among the people. Some persons are getting 1 lakh and some person is getting 1,000. It is not, it should not get happen, okay? It should be equally. Equally means there must be an equality. Means somebody is getting 10,000, somebody is getting 8,000, it is okay. But somebody is getting 1 lakh and somebody is getting 1,000, this is not equal distribution of income. So with this 5-year plan, they focus on this income development for the people, and to they look also that it should get equally distributed among all the peoples of the country. So with this we have completed this economic development measures, 5 years plan. Okay, next is the implementing of poverty eradication program. Eradication means making it out, okay, it's there in the keyword. Implementing of poverty eradication program. Eradication means kicking out. In 1960, government implemented many programs for providing employment to people in both rural and urban areas. These programs are classified into two groups. Okay, these are classified into two groups. Here we will be going with the first group, that is self-employment program. Self-employment. See, it's not that I will go to somewhere for a job only. Okay, there are many works which I can do and I can increase my income. That is self-employment. Businessmen are self-employed, means they are doing something from their own. They are not going to any organization, they are not getting salary, they are doing of their own to get their income high. Many schemes to promote self-employment among poor and unemployed people has been taken up by providing loans at low rates of interest and subsidies. Okay, see, now the thing is that implementing a poverty eradication program. In that, what is there? In 1960, government implemented in 1960 onwards. Okay, government implemented many programs for providing employment to people in both rural and urban areas. These programs are classified into two groups. Okay, so from 1960 onwards only, government has focused that so that not only the jobs, people should get engaged in other work so that they can earn something and they can have their life in a good condition, okay, or healthy condition. So for that, what the first one they have implemented? They have implemented self-employment programs. Self-employment means business. Excuse me. Something I am doing of my own. Suppose I have started a shop. It means I am the owner of the shop, and from that only I will get the profit. I am not working for anybody else. Okay, so self, for this self-employed program, what is happening? To start a business, the main thing is the capital requirement, okay, or money is required. So bank is giving loan to the persons at a very subsidized rate, okay, so that they can do the business and they can also repay the amount. And so what is happening? Bank is also getting, means the government is telling that government is getting profit, but less profit, okay, but the person to whom they are giving, they can construct their business easily. Some significant schemes are as follows. These are the schemes they have provided. Integrated Rural Development Program in 1980. In 1980, they have developed some program for the rural development. Okay. Okay. Swarna Jayanti Grama Swarojgar Yojana SGSY in 1999. Swarna Jayanti Sahari Rojgar Yojana SSRY in 1997. Deen Dayal Antodaya Yojana or National Rural Livelihood Mission NRLM in 2011. These are the programs being implemented by the government for the self-employment program so that people can earn money from their own other than the job so that they can live their life easily. Okay, so in the next video, we will be going through the further most or move towards the further topic related to this. So implementing a poverty eradication program. Okay, this one is having two group. One is the self-employed program and one is the wage, related to wage, which we will be discussing in the next video. Okay, so I think you all understand about the self-employment program. Self-employment program means the businessmen who don't go for job to other organization. They are only a organization, or they are having a shop, whatever the business they are having, and from there only they are getting the income so that they can earn their livelihood to have a healthy life. Okay, so see you and see you in the next video, and thank you and have a nice day.